Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to be talking about Disney. Now, we're not really going to go too far into the weeds on the financials. The only reason I have this put up is because I just wanted to show you some basic metrics. So, I mean, right now, Disney has a P/E ratio of 74, which for a company this size that's been around this long, that's far too rich to be trading at that. And where am I? Am I in cash flows? No, I don't think I was. I'm on the income statement. But we come down here. I mean, just off the top of my head, I could use a multiple of 20 to figure this out. But now I don't know if they're using cash flows to invest. So that's something I would have to figure out. But I mean, there's a steep drop there. Yeah, basically what that is the effects of COVID shutting down their amusement parks. Now, why am I totally bearish on Disney? I'll tell you. It's because I have no confidence in what they're doing, right? So some of this is political. Mostly it's not. Mostly it's just attacking garbage writing. So what caused this? What prompted this? I did a video probably, I don't know, a month or two ago, maybe 3 months ago. I did a video on why I have no confidence in Disney. And at that point, I talked about them and their politicalization of the MCU. Now, I'll throw it out there. There's nothing wrong with inserting some of your own politics into a movie. I mean, if it's not gaudy and it's consistent with the character and who they are, you can put whatever politics you want in there. The problem becomes is when you go over politicizing your entertainment, you turn off the group that you're against, if you are indeed against them. So what am I saying by that? What I'm saying is, you know, if you go really hardcore right on a show, you're gonna disenfranchise liberal voters. If you go really far left, you're gonna disenfranchise right-wing voters. But if you just write terrible political entertainment, you please nobody. So what prompted this was I have Disney streaming. I got Disney Plus because I wanted to watch The Mandalorian. And boy, was season 2 of The Mandalorian slightly above mediocre. So being conditioned by Disney film with their awful writing in Star Wars made what would be a mediocre show excellent. Seeing Luke Skywalker come on screen again and kick some ass without any of Kathleen Kennedy's nihilism and her wanting to make every woman in the Star Wars universe just the bestest ever, flawless, perfect beings that can do anything a man can do but better without any training. So, after I got to the book of Boba Fett, and this just goes to the writing on their other shows, I couldn't even finish the book of Boba Fett. It was that god-awfully written that I tapped out on. I'm like, I'm done. I'm not wasting my time on this. So, when I went back, I said, all right, I want to watch the Obi-Wan series. This is Disney's last chance. And I haven't been watching the shows, but I said, all right, here's a good determination. I want to see the Obi-Wan Darth Vader fight. It's terrible. It's awful. Like, I've gone down the rabbit hole on the Disney shows. So the writing on The Mandalorian, which I thought was pretty good, was mediocre at best. like I said earlier, just because we've been conditioned to accept crap from Disney. This has nothing to do with your politics. I don't care about this. You're trying to sell Reva too hard, but that's fine. If that's a character you really want to introduce, you know, if you want to put a, which I think is going to be the arc, is that she's going to be redeemed in the end, that's fine. Put a character in there that you want to redeem. Problem is, don't start attacking people politically when they start talking about your garbage writing. Like, most of what I am seeing coming out of Disney is writing that is the equivalent of a creative writing class in junior high. And so the reason I'm saying that is not because I'm a writing snob. I just want a decent story. And if I'm going to pay you, I think you should create a decent story. And what does Disney do again, even after the Last Jedi debacle, and then with whatever Rise of Skywalker, whatever crap that was, whatever special needs short bus rider wrote the Rise of Skywalker, like, we're paying money here, okay? It's one thing if I'm watching a show on NBC and I don't have to pay for it. I just commercials, and I'll get up and go take a pee and come back and watch Friends. Friends had, I'll just go with Friends. The writing on Friends is mediocre at best, but I didn't have to pay for it. Okay, if it's on in the background. Disney Plus, I have to pay for. I said this a while ago. I have no confidence in their Phase 4 of Marvel, and I have less confidence in what they're doing with Star Wars. These are two huge intellectual properties. They should be generating just buckets and buckets of cash flow, and they are. But the problem is Disney is basically turning all of these products, they're turning it into a Star Wars farm, where they're just farming out lazy, uncreative show after show and just slapping the Star Wars name on it. This is what happens when you overpay for anything. They overpaid for an intellectual property. Now they have to recoup the money. So they're just putting out lazier and lazier shows. I mean, really honestly, from what I got watching the Obi-Wan fight, I go, all right, Darth Vader should be like the Terminators on screen. When Darth Vader shows up, you as the audience member should just go, oh crap, this is a bad dude, right? I don't know what I watched when I watched that Obi-Wan fight. And I'm admitting to you, I haven't watched the series and I'm not going to waste my time with it. Unless it pulls off a miracle in the last three episodes, I don't know what to tell you. If this is indicative, it's getting burned on Boba Fett. And getting burned on Boba Fett made me so, not angry, because I'm not going to get angry about this, but it turned me off so bad to Disney. All I said was, Obi-Wan's the last chance. And if this show doesn't pull through, I see no reason to pay Disney every month so that they put out crap content. I mean, this is the entire problem. And this goes over to a bigger problem of the streaming companies anyways, if you're buying their stock. What must-see TV does Netflix have besides Stranger Things and a few other IPs? I originally thought Netflix was going to get crushed by Disney, but Disney fell in the same trap as Netflix. They are putting out crap content that nobody wants to watch. And then they're getting angry at you, the viewer, because you don't watch their, you know, crap shows. So it comes down to, like, at what point And then Disney doubles down, right? Disney doubles down on the whole actress who plays Reva thing as racism. And I just look at it and I go, Disney, you thanked the same province that they are actively committing a genocide against the Uyghurs in. And you're going to lecture your fan base because they don't like the writing you did. You're mad because nobody wanted to see an emasculated Obi on screen. You know, it's like one thing if he's got PTSD, but dude, I'm paying my money. I want to see you function and I want to see you fight Darth Vader. And this whole thing is just lazy, stupid writers. And what it comes down to is I really do believe that they're going to put out a couple more Star Wars shows. And the only thing they're going to be left with is the absolute most hardcore of hardcore fans. I just don't see them retaining people. So what exactly, why exactly should I continue to pay Disney? And this is the entire problem with the streaming services in general. They put out so much content that is crap, and then they're not recouping their money, that it's not sustainable. It became this thing of quantity over quality, and that's where we are. So I don't know what to say. I just wanted to talk about that stock and the terrible decisions that are being made by management. I don't understand why Star Wars or Disney didn't learn from The Last Jedi and The Rise of Skywalker and The Eternals and other shows like that, that you can't force the audience to pay you money for crap content and then turn around and shame the audience with some sort of political weapon. Like, you know, though I didn't like Obi-Wan. It just really wasn't that good. The writing wasn't that good. That's racist. And you're like, bro, I'm actually just commenting on the writing. And this is what Disney has done. So, I mean, there's that on top of the fact that you are alienating your fans and you are hiring. Who are you hiring to make these shows? So, I don't know what more to say. I don't know if you liked Obi-Wan. I don't know why I got in the habit. I'm just tired today. Got in the habit of saying Obi-Wan. It's Obi-Wan. Let me know in the comment section what you think. But, I mean, this show is just awful. And I don't understand why Disney thinks they can just keep putting out awful crap. You can only put out awful crap for so long before you destroy the IP. And that is what is happening here. This show, I mean, yeah, I don't know what to tell you. I couldn't even really just get through the Darth Vader Obi-Wan fight because it's just terrible. So anyways, like and subscribe or don't. Leave me a comment on what you think. Whether you think Disney is destroying their IPs or what, I don't know. Maybe you're some whack job that actually likes the Obi-Wan series. So let me know. Anyways, like and subscribe or don't, and I'm out.